Good morning, Interborough. This is Mr. Johnston with the Pledge of Allegiance. Please rise. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Now stay tuned for this edition of Kaleidoscope.
Good morning, Interborough, and welcome to the Wednesday edition of K-Scoop. I'm Reef.
And I'm Sam with your morning announcements.
There will be a student council meeting today at 2:05 in the auditorium. Please ask your 10th period teacher for permission.
Listen up, seniors. Cap and gown measurements will be taken next week on February 15th and 16th during lunches. Cap and gown costs $25.
Mark your calendars. The Interborough College and Career Fair will be March 1st. This is a great opportunity to connect with schools and meet representatives.
Let's check in with Ms. Stamp for our Black History Month fact of the day.
Frederick Douglass was a man with ideas ahead of his time. Known primarily for his role in advocating for an end to slavery, Douglass was also an early civil rights and women's rights pioneer. Born the son of a slave and slaver, and separated at birth from his mother, Douglass was raised until the age of 6 by his grandmother. Once he reached maturity, 6 that is, he was sent into the fields to work, permanently separated from the family he knew. Douglass was transferred from home to home, and his treatment under his different masters varied from one extreme to the other. On the one hand, a benevolent wife of one of his masters taught him the basics of reading. On the other, he was whipped and beaten viciously for falling ill. His poor treatment and conviction that slavery was morally wrong led Douglass to seek to escape his conditions. He succeeded after 2 failed attempts at the age of 20. Once free, Frederick Douglass quickly became a leading voice for abolition in the United States. He worked with William Lord Garrison on The Liberator before beginning his own publication, The North Star. In addition to this publication, in which he rallied against the hypocrisy of Christians owning or defending slavery, Douglass also wrote an autobiography and went on speaking tours. Known as a brilliant orator, Douglass famously asked Americans, "What to a slave is the 4th of July?" This speech pointed out the hypocrisy of a national holiday to freedom when so many in the country were in bondage. Douglass spent his lifetime pointing out and fighting against hypocrisy and injustice, defeating segregation laws in New York schools, and challenging marriage laws by marrying a white woman nearly 100 years before either was recognized as legal in the United States. Douglass is an American hero whose moral leadership is something every politician should aspire to in the modern era.
Thanks, Ms. Damp. A very happy birthday to Ricky Zinn. I hope you have a great day.
Stay tuned for an important announcement from Kevin and Dan.
If you have a talent or have convinced yourself you have a talent, please sign up for the 2017 Mock Rock Talent Show, which will be on March 2nd.
And I'm hosting!
Sign-ups are in the main office. Please sign up by Thursday if you want to perform.
That's all announcements we have for today.
See you tomorrow, Interborough.